Hello yogis, and welcome to another Yoga Flow with me, the Bender Fit Yogi. My name is Rob and I will be guiding you through your practice today. Please keep in mind to always listen to your body. It's okay to challenge yourself, but never to the point of pain. Also, make sure that you're hydrating throughout your practice. If you like my videos, please subscribe and hit the like button. I hope you enjoy, and I'll see you on the mat. Sitting up tall, placing the hands on the knees, slightly pulling back, feeling the upper back muscles engage, opening up the chest, the shoulders, straightening the spine. Begin to breathe naturally, noticing the natural rise and fall of the chest as you inhale and exhale. Beginning to settle your energy. With each exhale, relax more and more, allowing the shoulders to drop. Beginning to connect the breath with the movement of the body. Acknowledging any random thoughts that might pop into your head, placing them in a bubble and pushing them away. Matching the breath with the movement will help you stay on track, keep you in the present moment. Whenever you do have those random thoughts, just come back to your breath. Now begin to extend your breath. Getting up to lung capacity, pausing, and then fully exhaling all the way down to the bottom of the belly, using the abs to squeeze the navel in towards the spine, getting all that stagnant air out. And then deep inhale. Pause at the top, full exhale. Take these at your own breath pace. Beginning to slow the mind down to match the breath, to match the energy. Relaxing the shoulders. Now as you inhale, let the lower belly expand out like a balloon. Ribs flare, chest opens nice and wide, all the way up to the collarbone, pause at the top. And then as you exhale, reverse chest, ribs and diaphragm. Bring that navel to the spine using your abs. Inhale, expand the belly. Let the ribs flare. Expand the chest open. Begin to exhale and reverse, taking a few of these at your own pace. Beginning to go inward. Again, slowing down the mind, slowing down the breath. Inhaling deeply, exhaling fully. Consciously breathing, begin to think of an intention that you would like to set for class today. It could be a number of things. It could be a mantra that you would like to repeat throughout the practice. So in combination with the breath, keep you present, bring you back to the present moment. It could be anything from, I am kind, I am generous. It can be a quality that you would like to emulate not only on your mat, possibly maybe throughout the rest of your day. Patience, kindness. It could be something centered around gratitude, showing gratitude. gratitude to yourself, receiving gratitude, showing forgiveness of others and yourself, guidance, letting the ego go and not being afraid to ask for guidance when needed. And throughout your practice, come back to your intention, kind of check base, see where you're at, make any modifications if you need to. Tall, we're going to bring the hands to the sides. As we inhale, the arms come up. Exhale, the hands to the heart center. Repeat, inhale. And exhale. Last time, inhale. This time as we exhale, the right hand comes a foot out to the side. We're going to inhale up through the left fingertips. And as we exhale, we're going to bend over that left ear, bending the right elbow. Each inhale gives us length. Each exhale, bend a little bit deeper. And on this inhale, we're going to bring the right arm up to meet the left. Then we're going to bring the left hand down. Inhale up through the right fingertips. Exhale, bend over the right ear. Inhaling for length. Exhale, bend. This time, inhale. Left arm comes up to meet the right. As we exhale, we're going to bring the right arm behind us. Left hand comes to the outside of the right knee. We're going to sit up tall. Exhale, gently twist, looking over the right shoulder. Release the gaze, look to the left. Release the forward, switch sides. Left arm comes behind, right arm comes up and over, outside of left knee. Inhale, sit up tall. Exhale, gently twisting, looking over the left shoulder. At the bottom, maybe walk the fingertips out to the top of the mat, and then allow the forehead to fall. Inhale, come back up to a tall spot, across the positioning of the legs change. Inhale, sit up tall. Arms come up. Exhale, fold forward. At the end, releasing the forehead to the mat. Inhale, and back up, see it tall. From here, we're going to transition into tabletop. So however you need to, carefully come to tabletop. making sure the wrists are underneath the shoulders, the knees are underneath the hips. And then as we inhale, we're going to open up the chest and the heart to the front of the room, arching the back. Exhale, round the back, release the head. Again, inhale. Begin to do this at your own pace, your own breath. Again, connecting the movement with the breath. Shoulders come up over the fingertips. Maybe you're on a figure eight. Switch directions if you haven't already. Coming back to a neutral spine. Tuck the toes. We're going to push into the hands equally, spreading the fingertips, applying deep pressure or weight, not dumping into the wrists, but on the finger pads, especially the index and the thumb. And then as we exhale, we're going to push the sits bones up towards the sky, chest, the thighs, straightening the legs. Your first downward facing dog, so go ahead and walk it out, bending one knee at a time. Maybe moving the hips, coming up onto the toes. And then as we inhale, we're going to round the back, bring the shoulders above the wrist, upper push-up position. Exhale, the knees down, sit back, toes still tucked, look in between the hands. Inhale, tabletop. Exhale. Downward facing dog. Inhale, round the back, upward push up. Exhale, knees down, sit back. And then repeating this at your own pace, trying to get the movement as fluid as possible. Every time we come forward, we're inhaling. Sit back, we're exhaling. Beginning to warm up the shoulders, the hips, beginning to lubricate the joints. Meeting the back and downward facing dog. Coming up onto the toes, bending the knees, look in between the hands, and step one foot at a time. Up to the front of the mat, forward bend, bending the knees, allowing the stomach and chest to come in contact with the top of the thighs, grabbing either elbow, swing back and forth. Release the hands to the mat. As you inhale, come to a flat back. If you want, come to a block with the hands or shins. Exhale, fold forward. And as we inhale, one vertebrae at a time, slowly, with the last thing lifting being the head, arms reach. Exhale, the hands to the heart center. Release palms facing forward. Mountain pose, making sure the ankles and the knees are aligned, the knees and the hips and the shoulders with the ears, and bring that head back as if you're standing up against the wall. Beginning to warm up the body, inhale the arms up, exhale, dive forward,
Inhale to a flat back. Exhale, plant the hands, step back. Lower down, chaturanga. Option to keep the thighs in contact with the mat, cobra. Or all the way up into upward facing dog. And then pushing back, downward facing dog. Coming up onto the toes, bend the knees, step or float. Inhale to a flat back. Exhale, fold. Inhale with a flat back.
Come to stand.
Exhale to hands to heart center.
Release and lift.
Dive. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, plant the hands. Floater step. Chaturanga. To cobra or upward facing dog, to downward facing dog, up on the toes, bend the knees, step for float, inhale flat back, exhale fold, inhale come all the way up, arms touch, palms touch, exhale, heart center, repeat one last time, inhale, exhale dive. Flat back, release, step or float, chaturanga, to cobra, upward, to downward facing dog, taking three deep breaths. Throughout your practice, make sure that you are hydrating. You will see me hydrating a lot. All the music that you hear today is also on my YouTube channel, The Bender Fit Yogi, under my playlist. I believe it's going to be Sunday, the date, and then Yoga Flow. Then from downward facing dog, inhale, round the back, shoulders over the wrists. Option to drop the knees. Otherwise, we're going to slowly count of five, come down to our belly. Elbows stay in. One, two, come forward on the toes. Three, four, five, hold, and release. Bringing the hands behind you, arms to the sides. Bring the feet wide. Edges of the mat, corners. As we inhale, we're going to lift the chest, the head, the arms, the thighs, and the feet up off the mat. Focus. Option to keep the thighs and the feet down. Otherwise, exhale. Inhale and lift. Engaging the abs, the glutes, feeling the engagement of the shoulder blades, the triceps, the low back. Exhale, release, left cheek on the mat. Round two, exhale. Inhale, lift. Trying to get that chest even further up off the mat. And release, right cheek on mat. Third and final round. Exhale. Inhale, lift. Try to get the shoulders down and away from the ears. And release. Left cheek. Bringing the hands back underneath the shoulders.
coming onto the fingertips. Maybe bring the hands either on the edge of the mat or a little outside of the mat. And then as you inhale, just come up into cobra. Exhale, slowly lower down. And repeat, come up and down. Last time. Plant the hands underneath the shoulders. Push back into tabletop. Bring the knees to the edge of the mat. Big toes come together, sit back. Child's pose. Rounding the back. If you ever lose control of the breath or need to just regain your composure, this is your resting pose that you can choose, either this or downward facing dog. Just come here, take a moment, rejoin the class. Inhale, come back up to tabletop. Exhale, push back, downward facing dog. Inhale, lift that right leg up. Hold. Bend the knee, open the hips up to the side of the room, point the toe.
I was looking for you, I didn't know there was something to find.
Square the hips, knee to chest, hold. Round the back.
I'm trying so hard to rewind.
And then release, step through, back knee comes down. Inhale, come up to either the knee. Our arms can reach. As we inhale, we're going to lengthen up through the fingertips. And then as we exhale, we're going to drop the hips towards the earth. Inhale. Exhale, bring the hands to the mat. Come up off that back knee. If you need to, bring the foot a little closer, straighten the front leg. Allow the torso to fall over that front thigh. Option to come up onto your blocks. Now as we straighten the front leg, we're going to float the back leg up off the mat. So bend the knee and straight, standing
scissors.
Use your blocks. Just release the hands to the mat, allowing the chest to fall towards the thigh. Exhale, step back. High lunge. Front foot back. Take your vinyasa to downward facing dog. Left leg lifts. Inhale. Fold. Bend the knee. Open up the hips. Point the toe. Making sure you're still equally distributing between the hands. Exhale. Square the hips. Knee to chest. Hold. Step through, back knee comes down. Inhale, the hands up to the knee, or all the way up, extended towards the sky. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, release the hips. Inhale, and exhale. Exhale the hands to the mat. Bring that fat
back foot in a little closer. Straighten the front leg. Again, option to use the blocks. Torso over, front thigh. Maybe on each exhale, allowing the chest to fall a little bit closer. Feeling the stretch in the calves and the hamstrings. Transitioning, coming up onto the front leg, floating the back leg. Releasing the chest, close the thigh. Maybe grab a hold of the ankle or calf. Release, step back, high lunge. Left foot comes back. Vinyasa or downward facing dog. Taking three deep breaths. Hydrating. Step through, back foot 45, coming up into warrior one. Checking your form, knee over ankle, external rotation, pull back, hips, shoulders, facing forward, engage the low belly, strong back wave, soft shoulders and neck. And each exhale, lunge a little bit deeper into that front leg. Holding this pose for a little bit longer. Building strength and endurance. Again, coming back to the breath. If you chose a mantra, come back to the mantra. Come back to the present. Experiencing the pose without judgment or reaction. You'll be surprised what the body can do if you put your mind to it. Exhale, we're going to bring the hands to the cactus and arms. Arch the back. Inhale, release and lift. Exhale, cactus. Inhale. Exhale, this time release the hands behind the back and release the fingers. And you inhale, offer the chest and heart up. And as you exhale, come down over that front thigh. Option to bring the shoulder and the inside of the knee. Release the arms and hands towards the front of the room. Release the neck and head. Humble warrior. Option to keep the hands forward or bring them to the heart center or down to the block. If you need to regain your balance and then come back to an arm variation. So whenever you're ready. Step back. Warrior one. Inhale the arms up. Exhale. Hands to mat. Step back. Downward facing dog or take your vinyasa. This time the left leg lifts. Exhale, knee to chest, step through. Rise, warrior one. Checking your form. Each exhale, a little bit lower into that lunge. Making sure the hips and the shoulders are facing forward. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, cactus the arms. Arch the back, look up. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, release the hands behind the back. Interlace the fingers. Inhale, offer the heart. Chest up. Look up. Exhale. Folding over that front thigh. Again, option to bring the shoulder inside the knee. Release the hands, inhale, coming back up. Warrior one. Coming onto the ball of that back foot. Transitioning into warrior three, whenever you're ready. If you fall, just regain your balance. Find your drishti, your focus point. Step back, warrior one. Exhale, hands to the heart center. Step back, downward facing dog, or vinyasa. Taking three deep breaths. Hydrating. Leaning back and downward facing dog. Right leg lifts. Exhale, knee to chest, step through. Back foot parallel with the back of the mat. Windmill the arms open. Warrior two. Checking the form. Exhale, rotate. If you can't, bring the back hip in. That's going to open up some space. Back into socket. Knee over ankle. Grounding. Pinky toe side of the back foot, strong back leg. Relax the neck, shoulders, but extend deeply through the front and back hands. Flip that front palm, inhale it up. Back hand can come down the back leg or behind the back. Remembering to lunge into the front leg. Inhaling back up into warrior two. Exhale, forearm to thigh. Top arm reaches up and over the left ear. Bring that pinky down, thumb up. Grounding through the back foot. Imagine pulling energy from Mother Earth all the way up through the ankle, the calf, the thighs, the side body, shoulders, arms up and out through the fingertips, back into the universe. Inhale, coming back up, warrior two. Straighten that front leg. Inhale, reach towards the front of the room. Can't reach any further. Exhale, release. Left arm comes up. Gaze can either be down or up at the lifted fingers, depending on your neck. Why don't you leave me? transitioning into half moon. We're going to bring the block or hand, a foot out in front of the pinky toe. Straighten the front leg, float the back leg up off the mat, keeping the hips and shoulders square to the side room. So whenever you're ready. And the knees step back, warrior two. Bring the front toes in. Inhale, the arms up. Exhale, dive. Feet, the cat. Stretching, hamstrings stretching. Heels wider than the toes. Inhale, come to a flat back. Exhale, release and fold. Two more. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. Last time, inhale. Exhale, fold and hold. Now you bring the hands to the ankles or feet. Maybe reverse the positioning of the hands using the biceps to pull. Release the hands back underneath the heart. Transitioning, rotating, coming up to the front of the mat. High lunge. Front foot comes back. Downward facing dog or vinyasa. Downward facing dog, left leg lifts. Inhale. Exhale, knee to chest, step through. Warrior two, opposite side. Checking your form. Engaging the low belly, neck in alignment with the spine. I have a bad habit of going forward. Make sure you bring the hip back. Again, bring that back hip in a little. Need room to open and externally rotate. Enjoying the pose. Pause your time. Not thinking about what you're doing the rest of the day, just be present. Front palm flips, inhale, the arm up. Back hand down the leg or behind the back. Inhale, warrior two. Exhale, forearm to thigh. Right arm reaches over. The silence is in and it feels bottom like shoulder forward, top shoulder back. And I know you feel like gaze up or down. Again, grounding through the side of that back foot. Pulling that energy from Mother Earth up through the leg, side body, out through the fingertips. Leading with the right hand, come back up. Warrior two. Straighten the front leg. Inhale, reach. Exhale, release. Especially if you're going to be transitioning into half moon, have it handy. All we need is hope. And for that we have each other.
half moon whenever you're ready. Bend the front knee, step back, warrior two. Front toes come in, inhale, palms touch. Exhale, fold. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. Two more, inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, and hold. Back underneath the heart. Rotate to the front of your mat. High lunge. Left foot comes back. Take your vinyasa, your downward facing dog. Three deep breaths. Towel off. Get a drink.
These lonely walls have changed the way I feel. The way I feel.
From downward facing dog, right leg lifts.
And nothing else matters now.
Exhale, bring the knee to the wrist. Foot can come either underneath the hips, or if you're flexible, you can bring it up towards the left hand. Back leg straight out behind you. At first, come up tall. And then if you're flexible, coming down to the elbows maybe. Maybe extending the arms all the way out or the mat. Keeping the hips level, if you have a difficulty, you can bring a block underneath the buttock of the bent knee. And then bring the forehead to the mat and breathe. We're going to be here for a few breaths, so on each exhale, allow the muscles to loosen, going deeper into the pose. Back up, hands on the mat, transitioning, tuck the toes, move the block, bring that back knee up off the mat, and kick back and up, and release, left leg lifts, inhale, exhale, knee to wrist, again, positioning the foot, where it's best for you. I am tighter on this side, so my foot will stay back, and at least initially, again if you need a block, and then come down. Coming back up,
moving the block, tuck the back toe, lift the back knee,
front knee to chest, kick back it up, and release down, rounding into upper push-up, knees come down, legs come to the side, extend, and bring the bum up closer to the front, bring the soles of the feet together, bounding, sitting up tall, allowing the hips to open, the knees to release, the groin muscles to loosen. Extending the legs out in front. Sit up tall. Inhale, arms up, palms touch. Exhale, flat back. Come out forward over the leg. If you need a strap, grab a strap, a towel, a t-shirt. And then as you exhale and the muscles start to loosen, release the forehead. Allow the chest to fall closer and closer to the tops of the thighs. Option just to bring the hands to the mat. Inhale, coming back up. Bending the knees, option to keep the hands in the back of the thighs. Otherwise, you're going to extend the feet out and bring the arms up. And as I count to 10, we're going to slowly lower down one vertebrae at a time onto our backs. So 10, 9, 8, feel the shake, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, release. Bring the knees into the chest. Rock side to side, lower arm bones up. Line the knees to fall to the right. Extending the left arm out to a T, gaze over the left fingers. Knees come back to chest, switch sides. Back to the chest. Preparing for our final resting pose of Shavasana. Squeezing the knees in tight, forearms come around the shins. Flexing the feet, engaging all the muscles, the glutes, the calves, the thighs, the abs, the biceps as you pull the knees in tighter. Bring the forehead
to the knees. I'm going to count to three. Once I reach three, we're going to extend the legs out, allow the feet to walk open. Arms release to the sides, palms up to receive, palms down to ground, mother earth. Shoulders, upper back, release down to the mat, soft mat. So one, squeeze. Two, squeeze tighter. Begin to bring the attention back to the physical body, the toes and fingers, rotating the elbows, wrists and ankles. Maybe stretch up overhead, good morning. Bring the knees to the chest and then slowly and carefully come up to seated. Time to show gratitude to yourself for coming onto your mat and doing your practice today. Being consistent, coming on each day, even if it's only 5 minutes. Taking that time for yourself to collect your thoughts, settle your energy, to go inward so that you can continue through the rest of your day without reaction to anything negative that may happen. Grounding you. As always, I'd like to thank you for allowing me to come into your home for an hour each day. I'm honored to guide you through your practice. I appreciate you, and I bow to you. Namaste.